Want to get back to Robert. He's been saying that the temperatures have been dangerously hot outside. In fact, heat is the number one weather-related killer in the United States. But why is the heat and humidity so dangerous? You've been throwing all kinds of facts at us tonight, and I'm interested to hear more on
this. Yeah, you know, a lot of us aren't acclimated to the heat yet.
Yeah.
This is the first real slap in the face from summer that we've gotten. So I wanted to talk about the heat index and ways you can keep yourself safe when it gets hot. So first, we're going to take a look at our two little guys here when we talk about the heat index. And it's like the wind chill. It's what it feels like to your exposed skin. So when we have low humidity, when the air is dry, it allows more moisture to evaporate off your skin. And evaporation is a cooling process. That's why if your hand is wet and you hold it out the window of your car, it feels really cold because that water is evaporating. When we have high humidity, high dew points, a lot of moisture just chilling in the atmosphere, it really stymies the evaporation off of your body. That sweat just kind of sits there and it doesn't cool you. And you look like our little guy here, miserable, who's sweating profusely. That's the way many of us will look tomorrow with that uncomfortable high humidity values. And when it gets that humid outside, it can lead to heat stress, heat stroke, and heat exhaustion. So these are tips to keep yourself safe when you look like our little guy here who's sweating horribly. So as we mentioned, it's common sense here. Don't leave your pets, don't leave your kids inside a parked vehicle. We've already had 3 children die inside cars this year across the country. Drink plenty of water, keep yourself hydrated. You want to reduce strenuous activities. Tomorrow and this week is not the day for that 1 o'clock in the afternoon 3-mile run. That's not a good idea. You want to find shade or stay in air conditioning. And as you have heard me say many times, lightweight, light colored clothing. You want to wear those whites, the light pinks, the baby blues, not the blacks, not the browns, not the navy blues. You keep those earth tones, those fall colors at home, because those darker colors just absorb all that energy from the sun instead of those light colors, which it bounces off your clothes and reflects back into the atmosphere and you're a little bit cooler. So if you are outside, here are the signs of heat exhaustion. You could be dizzy, you could be thirsty, you could be sweating heavily, you could feel a little sick, feel a little weak. That's when you need to step back and say, okay, I gotta unbutton my shirt a little bit, sip some cool water, not cold water, because your body doesn't absorb cold water until it becomes warm. If you have a friend that might be suffering from heat stroke, they could be confused, they could be very dizzy, or they could unfortunately become unconscious. And that's when you gotta call 911 immediately and get medical professionals involved, because you can, unfortunately, you can really be injured from heat stroke. So again, a lot of this we've gone over before, but it was time for a refresher because of how hot it's been, Paige. So just use common sense this week and you should be okay.
Hey, love the visual aids. Love that information, Robert. Thank you. Very helpful.